In this video, we're going to finish out the Simplifying Radical Expressions worksheet on the CUDA software website under the Infinite Algebra 1 section. Picking up where we left off with number 21, we're first going to start by finding the largest perfect square that goes into 125. 125 can be written as 25 times 5, where that 25 can be written as 5 squared. So 5 squared times 5 equals 125. So I'll have 2 times the square root of 5 squared times 5 times v. Now I'll be able to pull out that 5 since the square root will cancel out that exponent of 2, and I'll be left with 5 and v within the radical. So outside my radical, I'll have 2 times 5, and inside of it, I'll have 5 times v. 2 times 5 is 10, so 10 times the square root of 5v is my solution in number 21. In number 22, 24 can be rewritten as 4 times 6, where 4 is that perfect square of 2 squared. So 2 squared times 6 equals 24. So I'll have negative 8 times the square root of 2 squared times 6, and then k to the third I'll rewrite as k squared times k, since k to the 2 times k to the first equals k to the 2 plus 1, which equals k cubed. And k to the first is simply k. So now I'll be able to pull out a 2 and a k, and inside my radical I'll still have 6 and k. Because remember, that square root will cancel out these exponents of 2. So I'll have negative 8 times 2 times k times the square root of 6k. Negative 8 times 2 is negative 16, and we're multiplying that by k, and then by the square root of 6k. So negative 16 times k times the square root of 6k is my solution in number 22. In number 23, I'll rewrite 192, finding the largest perfect square. 192 is divisible by 4, but even more so than that, 192 is divisible by 64. That's the largest perfect square, would be 64. And 192 is 64 times 3. So that's 8 squared times 3. And I found 64 as the largest perfect square using trial and error on my calculator. So I first took 192, divided it by 4, divided that by 4, and divided that by 4 again. So 4 times 4 times 4 times 3 equals 192, so I simply multiplied my 4s together to get 64, which, when you multiply perfect squares together, the result is a larger perfect square. And if you're confused on how to find the largest perfect square that's a multiple of a number, refer back to the first video on this worksheet in which I go more in depth on locating that. But knowing that it's 64, we'll rewrite number 23 as negative 4 times the square root of 8 squared times 3 times x. So I'll be able to pull out that 8, so I'll have negative 4 times 8 times the square root of 3x, which is negative 32, since negative 4 times 8 is negative 32, times the square root of 3x. That's my solution for number 23. Moving on to number 24, I'll be able to rewrite my whole number 8 as 4 times 2, which is 2 squared times 2. So I'll have 2 times the square root of 2 squared times 2 times p squared, and I'll leave that as p squared because it has an exponent of 2. However, q cubed I'm going to rewrite as q squared times q, or q to the first, since q squared times q to the first is q to the third, and then I'll multiply that by r. So now anything with an exponent of 2 can be pulled out. So I'll pull out my base of 2, my base of p, and q. So I have 2 times 2 times p times q times the square root of 2qr, since those are left within my radical. 2 times 2 is 4, so I have 4pq, 4 times p times q, times the square root of 2 times q times r, the square root of 2qr. 4pq times the square root of 2qr. And number 25, my whole number is 216, which I know that 216, the largest perfect square that goes into that is 36. That's 36 times 6 equals 216, which is 6 squared times 6. So I'll rewrite number 25 as negative 4 times the square root of 6 squared times 6 times x squared times y squared times z. Now I'll be pulling out 6, x, and y, since they all have an exponent of 2, and within my radical, I'll still have 6 and z. So I'll have negative 4 times 6 times x times y times the square root of 6 times z. So that will simplify to negative 4 times 6, which is negative 24 times x times y times the square root of 6z. That's my solution in number 25. And number 26, 24 I know can be rewritten as 2 squared times 6, since 2 squared is 4 and 4 times 6 is 24. So I have negative 3 times the square root of 2 squared times 6, since that's 24, and a to the fourth I'll rewrite as a squared squared, because a squared squared equals a to the 2 times 2, which is a to the fourth, and then I'll multiply that by b squared, and then c to the third, I'll rewrite as c squared times c. So now everything with an exponent of 2, that base, I'll be able to pull out. So I'll pull out a 2, I'll pull out an a squared, and since a squared is squared, that exponent of 2 will cancel out. Then I'll have b and c. So I'll have negative 3 times 2 times a squared times b times c times the square root of what's left in my radical, which is 6 and c. Negative 3 times 2 is negative 6, so I'll have negative 6 a squared times b times c times the square root of 6c. That is my simplified solution in number 26. In number 27, 16 is already a perfect square. 16 is 4 squared. But then I can rewrite x to the fourth and y to the fourth as x squared squared and then y squared squared. And then that will still get multiplied by z. So I'll pull out my 4, my x squared, and my y squared, since those exponents of 2 will cancel out. So the only thing I'll have left within my radical is z. So I'll have 3 times 4 times x squared times y squared times the square root of z. And that all simplifies down to 3 times 4, which is 12, times x squared times y squared times the square root of z. That's my solution in number 27. In number 28, 48 can be written as 16 times 3, which 16 is that perfect square, which is 4 squared times 3. So I'll have negative 2 times the square root of 4 squared times 3 times a cubed, I'll write as a squared times a to the first, or a, b to the fourth, I'll write as b squared squared, and c squared, I'll leave as c squared since it already has an exponent of 2. Now I'll be able to pull out a 4, an a b squared, and a c, since each of those are raised to a power of 2. So I'll have negative 2 times 4 times a times b squared times c, and then in the radical, I'll still have 3 and a. So 3 times a within my radical. Simplifying that, negative 2 times 4 is negative 8. And then if I want my exponents in order of degree, b has a degree of 2. So then I'll write b squared, and then I'll multiply that by a and c. So b squared times a times c times the square root of 3 times a. That's negative 8b squared times a times c times the square root of 3a. And I wrote my b first because the degree of b was higher than the degree of a and c, which both had a degree of 1. And number 29, 75 is 25 times 3. So I'll rewrite that as 6 times the square root of 5 squared, which is 25 times 3, that's 75, times m times p squared times, and then q to the third, or q to the 3, I'll write as q squared times q to the first, or simply q. That way I'll be able to pull out a q. So now I'll pull out 5, p, and q, and within my radical I'll still have 3, m, and q. So 6 times 5 times p times q times the square root of 3 times m times q. 6 times 5 is a positive 30, so I'll have 30 times p times q, 30pq times the square root of 3mq. That's my solution in number 29. Now on to number 30, the last problem on this worksheet. If you haven't done so already, here's a friendly reminder to click that like button and subscribe to my channel. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated. Not to mention, sharing this video also shows your support. Now 36 is already a perfect square, that's 6 squared. So I have 4 times the square root of 6 squared times x squared, and I want to rewrite y cubed so that I have an exponent of 2. So I'll write that as y squared times y to the first, which is simply y, and then z to the fourth, I also want to have an exponent of 2, so I'll write that as z squared squared. So now I'll be pulling out 6, x, y, and z squared. So all I will have left within my radical is a y. So that's 4 times 6 times x times y times z squared times the square root of y. 4 times 6 is equal to 24, and because my z has a degree of 2, that will go next in the order of multiplication, just to keep it uniform. So 24 times z squared times x times y times the square root of y. That's my solution in number 30. And again, I wrote z squared before x and y because x and y only have a degree of 1, and my degree of 2 is greater than 1. So 24z squared times x times y times the square root of y is my final solution on this video and in this worksheet. Again, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share.